At the top of the Keli Mutu volcano in Indonesia, you'll find three lakes, all sitting right next to each other. Two of them even share a wall, but each one is a different, vivid color, and sometimes those colors change. So why are they all different, and where do those striking colors come from? The short answer is that they're all connected to the deeper volcanic system in different ways. And as scientists were studying how that's possible, they came across something even cooler, a new technique that could help us study color-changing landscapes all over the world. Keli Mutu is a cone-shaped stratovolcano on the island of Flores in Indonesia. Some locals say that its three lakes are home to the souls of the dead. The easternmost lake is Tiwu Atapolo, which loosely translates to Bewitched Lake or Enchanted Lake. It's believed to house the departed souls of bad people. Right next to Tiwu Atapolo is Tiwu Nua Murikoo Phi, the Lake of Young Men and Maidens. And a little ways to the west lies the Lake of the Elders, Tiwu Ata Bupu. While Keli Mutu's last eruption was back in 1968, it's been steadily leaking volcanic gases through both underground and underwater vents for decades. And it's thanks to those gases, along with deposits from within the volcanic system, that all three of the lakes get their rich colors. But what's even cooler is that they've all changed color at different points in the past. Tiwu Atapolo and Tiwu Nuu Murikoo Phi are usually some variation of green or turquoise, but Tiwu Atapolo sometimes turns dark red, and Tiwu Nuu Murikoo Phi occasionally shifts to white. Tiwu Atabupu has been white or green before, but it's black now. Despite being fed by the same volcanic system, each of these lakes has its own unique chemistry that gives them their distinctive colors. Or at least we think so. There hasn't been a lot of fieldwork done on the actual chemical composition of the lakes. It's pretty hard to get down there and collect samples, especially at Tiwu Atapolo and Tiwu Nuu Murikoo Phi. Their walls are several hundred feet high and practically vertical. But in the 90s, researchers managed to scoop up some of the water by stringing cables across the lakes and flying sample containers down. They analyzed the elements and chemicals that were in the lake water, which could offer some clues about where their colors come from. For starters, they think that the greenish hue of Tiwu Atapolo and Tiwu Nuu Murikoo Phi is most likely due to dissolved iron-containing chemicals because they found iron in water samples from all three lakes. Most people think of iron as a grayish metal, but iron atoms can also be part of other chemicals. In that case, the iron atoms usually take on a positive charge, and when they do, they also change color. Though scientists didn't determine the charge on the iron they found in the lakes, lots of chemicals that contain iron ions with a charge of 2+ are blue or green, and other volcanic lakes that have a similar color, like the one atop Aso volcano in Japan, get their greenish tint from iron too. Funny enough, iron might also be responsible for Tiwu Atapolo's red phases. There's some evidence that it tends to turn red in the rainy season. Rainfall dilutes the lake, which can make it less acidic. That, in turn, could lead to more iron ions with a 3+ charge ending up in the water. It's like the lake is rusting. Unlike Tiwu Atapolo, Tiwu Nuu Murikoo Phi's white phases aren't related to iron. Instead, scientists think that lake turns white when the volcano dumps a bunch of sediment into it. When a volcanic vent burps a bunch of gas into the lake, it kicks up dirt near the bottom. Those tiny dirt particles get suspended in the lake water. They reflect light really well, which makes the lake appear brighter and lighter in color. Tiwu Atapolo is basically the opposite of Tiwu Nuu Murikoo Phi, because the volcanic vents that feed Tiwu Atapolo have been fizzling out over time. Without a steady supply of gas bubbles kicking up those sediments, the lake has been settling down. That lack of suspended gunk makes it less reflective, which could contribute to its moody color. Despite how close they all are, the three lakes aren't connected, but Tiwu Atapolo and Tiwu Nuu Murikoo Phi are both getting a steady stream of minerals from the volcano's hydrothermal system. It's possible that water and gas circulating through different parts of the mountain pick up different elements and carry them to each of the lakes. Like I said before, it's pretty tough to actually get down there and test what's going on when the lake changes color, but we can monitor the color changes themselves using satellite images. Landsat satellites have been photographing Earth's surface pretty much continuously since 1972. A 2018 study combed back through 30 years of images of the Keli Mutu lakes and found some connections between the lake's colors and the volcano's activity. Back in June 2013, Indonesian volcanologists put out an alert for the area around Tiwu Atapolo. They heard the water splashing and bubbling, smelled sulfur, and saw plants wilting up to 2 kilometers away from the lake. The Landsat study found that Tiwu Atapolo had unexpectedly turned red a few months before in January, and it stayed like that for about a year. The scientists suggested that the lake's color changes might provide early evidence of volcanic activity, which researchers know happened right before Keli Mutu Volcano's eruption in 1938. Though we still don't know for sure if the color changes could be a warning sign, the scientists published the code they used to analyze the lake's color shifts in the satellite images. Somewhere down the line, other scientists could apply that code to images of other volcanic lakes to look for early warning signs of volcanic grumblings. But what's even more exciting is that researchers now think this technique for processing satellite images could be applied to any landscape that changes color on a seasonal scale, like forests or farmland. For example, some scientists have used satellite images to track urban growth in parts of Nicaragua, which could help protect nearby ecosystems. So these three weird lakes atop a volcano in Indonesia may have led to a new way of tracking all kinds of trouble in our world, which is just the latest thing that makes Keli Mutu so cool. Well, I guess technically it's hot, but you get the idea.